So now, you guys, briefly introduce yourselves in Malay.
Oh, what do you need me to say?
So, name, age, and role in the team.
Wait, need to translate. I need to translate three times. Chinese to English to Malay.
What the f***?
Oh my god!
Okay, nama saya Pung Kok Sing.
Yeah.
Saya juga dikenali sebagai Ozra Weki. Umur saya 25.
24.
I think it's better that we do it in English.
Okay. Good, this is what I'm good at. Okay. Hey guys, my name is Pung Kok Sing, also known as Ozra Veki. I'm currently playing jungle for SEAGM, and I'm also team captain of our team. I'm currently 24 years old. Nice to see you.
Hi guys, I'm Chan Rong Han, aka RH. I'm 27 this year and I play the Baron lane for SEM9.
Hello guys, I'm Chen Chin Li, aka Winter. I'm playing for support role and I'm 21 years old this year.
Hey guys, my name is Liu Guan Chen, also known as Sagi. I currently play for the Dragon lane for SEM9 and I'm 21 years old this year.
Hey guys, I'm Jonathan and I'm also known as Chili and I'm playing mid lane for SEM9 and I'm 26 years old this year.
Hi guys, I'm Harris Alexei, also known as Swag. I'm 27 this year and I'm the analyst for the team.
I didn't know you're 94.
What day, what day?
We are in a retirement home. Old folks home.
What are three factors that make you think that SEM9 is attractive? Why do you like SEM9?
Boss handsome.
My boss is rich and nice. They are my sugar daddies.
So it's probably how the people have been talking to me, because they have been incredibly down to earth, treat you like friend, like family. Like Tommy, he himself has helped me even though we just started working together, so I'm pretty impressed by it.
I think I kind of agree with Reki's point, like the organization is very friendly towards everyone. It's SEM9's like core values to be like value their employees as like we work as a family and all. And aside from that, I think because of this like logo, it's pretty cool, you know, it's a fox. It's pretty sexy. It's a tiger.
It's a camera.
It's a tiger that looks like a fox.
What has been your biggest challenge so far?
Winning team fights.
Right. Right. And it...
Chili pressing R before flashing a TF.
When it comes to team fight, I think we need to improve. And if we are good at team fights, I think next world champion. We are the next world champion. No guys, no one can stop us anymore.
Winter, you look like you have a lot on your mind. You just don't know how to say it.
Blank.
So this is a new team. What are each of you going to do differently?
Besides the team growth, obviously, I want to improve myself as a person, as a people that can lead better, because I'm a fairly emotional person. So that's something that I always wanted to work on, being able to communicate better, control my emotion better, and make better decisions for the teams, and really make the team feel like we all have each other backs.
Enjoy winning more.
For you to enjoy winning, you have to experience winning first.
Yes.
So you used to be on the front lines playing, but now you're like more of the analyst, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So how are those two roles different?
Well, I mean, I see things differently now. I see the bigger picture of the game, of the people I'm with. I see a big picture of myself as well as an individual. Learning how to communicate better, just be better. Learn the game more as well. Becky is amazing, Chili is amazing. So, but the other three.
Less amazing, but still good.
Wow.
Wow. On the count of three, point to the person who is most popular with women.
I don't have
one,
fingers for this.
One, two, three.
But personally, I think I hate this.
Different market, you know?
Chili also.
You want a cute boy? Big size guy.
Now we got a Chili here, the tall, cold guy.
Maybe I'm more into the big boy.
So, who is the most beloved member on the team currently? beloved by other members as well.
For me, I think it's RH and Swag maybe.
RH,
I think
RH and Swag.
They are good person, you know.
Of course, my ADC.
Wow, so nice.
My ADC every time.
I brought him here.
Okay, what is the new SEM9's mission and vision?
Our mission is to make it the worst. Our mission is to get out of group.
Get out of groups.
Yeah. Yeah.
Correct.
Statistically speaking, Malaysia has never made out of groups in RFC.
Let's go. Who do the cats love?
Winter loves the cat.
Yeah.
Scrub them.
Cut the nails. Take care of them. Ah. Oh.
Take out the
Give
poo.
Me some attention.
And then the cat go on the table and then play game with him.
And he's not angry. He's like,
play the game.
Hey, why are you here?
10-10 wife over.
Yeah,
you guys are missing out.
Wild Rift is a budding esport. What are your hopes in terms of the competitive scene growth?
Back in the days when League of Legends PC has those offline events, that would be so good. I would say that was the main reason why I wanted to play as a professional player. Back then, it's the stage, the fans, the cheers, the heights. Yeah, I would love to experience that again, and I wish that the next week there's an offline event.
And then for our community, I hope that we don't bash other people's community. We stay strong as one, and then we look to grow from there.
Alright. Is there anything you would like to say to Boss Tommy and SEM9?
Stay handsome.
Stay handsome.
Thank you.
I love him, man. Good boss.
Wow. I mean, like, you guys completely dominated the past two tournaments and it didn't occur to you, like, can I get a bigger bonus?
Oh, no, no.
He must be, like, super nice or something.
Would be good,
but yeah. Yeah, someone clip that in. For me, the first impression of, like, meeting him as a person and then, like, listening to him, like, speak is, like, ambitious and goals towards for the SEM9 team, I feel like I could rely on this guy to, you know, achieve like my dream in like becoming an esports person. So I feel like I can rely on him to like as a leader to, you know, bring forward us to this kind of goal.
He would message me on Facebook and ask how's everything, how's everyone, and that really showed, you know, what kind of person he is. So yeah, that's...
I mean, he's the first boss who taught me through my breakup.
At least now we know Ozora Becky is single and available, girls.
Not yet.
Broken up.
Slowly. Will be available soon.
Single but not available yet. But yeah, make a booking.
Chili, Winter, and RH?
Try not to let him down the second time.
I'm not even supposed to be doing this, dude.
It's okay. You got me now.
You got me now.
I can see that he's very passionate in like what he does in esports also. So like, hopefully, I don't need to change organizations again. So like, stay here long term and then like make this whole thing sustainable and like to be successful as an op, as a business, as a player.
Okay. What advice would you give to those pursuing an esports career?
It's not to say that not studying is the best, but at least make sure that if esports doesn't work out, you still have like an alternative path you can take. Don't gamble everything on esports. It's not the most consistent thing, but it is fruitful if you can find yourself a landing foot on esports.
Esport is for people that are disciplined. Because if you don't want to study because you think that playing game is fun, esport is probably not for you. You should be able to discipline yourself to be able to study while competing. At least you have to be able to do that. And if you be able to do that, you are a disciplined person and you can improve yourself, then esport is probably for you.
I think in terms of like if you are planning to be like a professional player, you have to know that it's not an easy path, and like any athletes out there, like you have to know that you are actually good at it for you to actually get into it. So don't take it as a rush, and like what I say, like you have to balance out your studies and stuff to make sure that you don't just have this one path that you can go for in your life.
Okay guys, that's all for today, and we will see you guys in the upcoming tournament.
On fire!
Bye guys!
I'm dying! Help me!
You're a good actor.
Good actor.
Holding my imaginary Oscar.
Holding my imaginary girlfriend's tie.